Welcome back to another storytelling session, my dear children. How have you all been? Are you curious to know which story I'm going to tell you today? Well, it is another Panchatantra story, but this time it is not about birds. It is about a snake and a frog. The name of the story is The Greedy Cobra and the King of Frogs. Once upon a time, there was a very big well with a lot of frogs in it. These frogs had a king and his name was Gangadatta. The frog king had a lot of his relatives in the same well too. Children, relatives of a person includes uncles, aunties, cousins, nieces, nephews, etc. These relatives of the frog king were never happy with anything he did. They used to always complain and find faults in the way the frog king ruled his kingdom. So, the frog king was very sad and fed up of his relatives. One day, the frog king climbed the walls of the well and left his kingdom. He wanted to take revenge on his relatives who had made him leave his kingdom. So, the frog king started to think on how to take revenge. As he was thinking, just then he saw a cobra snake entering his burrow. Children, do you know where the snake lives or what is its home called? Well, it is called as a burrow. It is nothing but a hole on the ground. The frog king goes to the entrance of the burrow and says, "Dear cobra, I am the king of frogs. I have come to make friends with you." The cobra hears this and thinks, "This is not the voice of any of my friends. This is definitely a stranger. Oh, I remember now. This is the voice of my natural enemy, the frog. How can a snake and a frog ever be friends? I'm sure someone is playing a trick to catch me. I should be very careful and not go out of the burrow." Thinking this, the cobra says to the frog king, "Who are you? Friendship between a snake and a frog never makes sense. We are natural enemies." "Yes, dear friend, what you are saying is true. We are indeed natural enemies. But I have come to you seeking your help. I want to take revenge on my relatives who are troubling me since many years. If you agree to help me, I can take you to the well, which is my forsaken kingdom, and you can eat as many frogs as you want." The cobra thinks and says, "A well is built of large stones. I do not have any legs. How will I be able to get into the well? Even if I do so, there is no way that I can catch a frog and climb the well and get out to eat it. There is no place in the well where I can sit and eat. Your offer does not make any sense. I cannot help you. Go away." The frog king says in a very promising voice, "Dear friend, there is a nice hole at the edge of the water in the well. You can live there, catch the frogs when you like, and sit and eat inside that hole. I can help you get to that hole, but you will have to promise me one thing. You will have to eat only my relatives who trouble me. You should not eat my friends or my family." The cobra thinks for a long time. "I have become old now and cannot hunt for my food every day for the rest of my life. A day will soon come when I will not be able to hunt and stay starved and die. I think the frog is giving a very good offer. If I go with the frog, I will have enough food for the rest of my life and I will never have to be hungry again. I better go with the frog king." So, the greedy cobra agreed to be the frog king's friend and went with him to the well. The frog king took the cobra to the hole as promised. Since then, the cobra started eating the frogs whenever it was hungry. After a few days, the number of frogs in the well came down and all of the bad relatives of the frog king were eaten. It had not even been a day since the frog king had started feeling happy and relaxed that the cobra came to him and said, "Dear friend, I'm starving since there are no more bad relatives of yours which are left to be eaten. Only your friends and family are remaining. I cannot even climb the walls of this well and go out to eat, and I don't have legs. You brought me here and promised me food for the rest of my life. I'm hungry now. So, it is your responsibility to give me food." The Frog King could not do anything as there was no other food for the cobra. The cobra started eating all other frogs one by one. The cobra also ate the close friends and family of the Frog King. Even the very own son of the Frog King was eaten by the cobra. The cobra was more hungry. It started demanding for more food again to the Frog King. The Frog King then realized that he was the only frog left in the well now. He understood that if he did not leave the well soon, the cobra would eat him too. So, the Frog King thought of a plan. So, he told the cobra, "Dear friend, will you allow me to go outside this well? If I can climb and go out, I can bring more frogs for you from the other wells and you will have enough food again." The cobra got even more greedy. It agreed for the Frog King to go out. The cobra waited and waited for many days without food, but the Frog King never came back. After waiting for a very long time, the cobra requested a lizard that lived in the walls of the well to go to the Frog King and request him to come back as he was missing his dear friend. When the lizard went and said this to the Frog King replied, "Please tell my dear friend cobra that I will never come back to the well again. He is starving for many days and such starved people can be cruel and eat his own friend in hunger." So, this way, the Frog King saved his life. The greedy cobra died after a few days without any food. This finishes today's story, children. So, what did we learn today? We learned that whenever we are in trouble, we should try to solve the problem ourselves. If we bring other people to solve our problems, we will be in more trouble, just like the Frog King lost all of his friends and family. The same thing applies to the cobra as well. Had the cobra not gone to the well, he would always have enough food for himself outside by hunting it. By becoming greedy, the cobra was killed of starvation. So, did you like today's story, children? If so, please click on the like button and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video, my dear children. Bye-bye.